Hello. It's really nice to be here once again with Suryacon, and I believe it is doing an enormous job of bringing the industry with a perspective of what is happening, but also what should be happening. And I am very glad to be here with you all, because this is more than what is happening. We as a company focus on what is likely to happen. And this is where we are, and we always say that we empower a grain of sand to capture the power of sun, because we are present. Yeah, because we are present into all kinds of technologies which are associated with solar, and we have been in the solar PV solar space, that is, for more than two decades, and have been kind of from the beginning. In the beginning, of course, it was more of a laboratory kind of business with public sector undertakings who wanted to evaluate the at a very R&D level the solar modules and solar cells. So we have been associated from that stage, but at the moment we offer our services for installation of equipment meant for the upstream side, that is module, cell, and then wafer, and then so on and so forth for even the refining of silica. We believe that Make in India will make an impact, and soon we will be seeing some signs of India going up the value chain in solar manufacturing space. We are also present in very many other things, and we try to bring the newer technology options for the industry as a whole. We represent around 30 world leading manufacturers, and we have a very well equipped, knowledgeable team which has been trained at the respective technology headquarters of our principals. I believe we have been talking about tariffs, we have been talking about the scenario which is currently there, and is it a good scenario or a grim scenario, but I think it all depends on us. If we think that 2.45 rupees or so is the bottoming out of the tariff, we should rethink, because Saudi Arabia has gone in for as much as 2 cents, which is equivalent of about 1 rupee 40 paise. So we let's keep watching what all happens. But that only means that there is a need to sharpen our approach towards the business. And how do we do that? By keeping a tab of what are the trends and what are the opportunities which are coming up. We see ourselves as a role of being catalyst in the PV industry, where we can say that our importance could be akin to salt in a food dish. So it is important, but it is very small in quantity. Now, we believe, and it has been covered, I believe, in the morning as well by Sharma, that energy storage is here. I believe if it took about 5 years or 6 years for solar to become what it is today, I think energy storage might not take more than 2 years to be in the same commercially viable space. So this is one trend which we see. In fact, we are also hearing that there are certain bodies, regulating bodies, which might start making it binding, that if you want to go for a solar project, you have to have a certain element of storage, because that is the, and they might give incentive for that. In fact, they may make it mandatory, which looks very contradictory. They might make it mandatory on one side, and they might incentivize it on the other side, because again, the gains will be salutary for the system as a whole, because it will address the stability issue. Because as we also hear, another trend which is coming up is day-ahead prediction. So now when you talk about day-ahead prediction, if you have an energy storage in between, you really are having a shield to play with. So I believe on one side, with the technological advancements and the commercialization of because of high scale, and also because of the compulsions that are showing their initial signs already, energy storage will catch up much faster. Ground mounted system with increasing use of trackers. When we used to talk about trackers about 3 years ago, we found that it was a concept selling. Today it is a reality, but what I believe is that whatever these gigawatt levels which we are talking on ground mounted, I think the percentage of single axis tracker, because that's the most popular and the most viable one, perhaps will gain more currency as the time passes. The third thing which is happening, which is being talked about in a significant way in various quarters, is 1500 volt DC system. So now this is perhaps a little in contradiction to what MFAS is trying to convey about the system and the safety. I fully buy the argument that safety has to be of supreme importance, and when you handle higher and higher voltages, in DC especially, you have to be very, very careful. But I'm sure the moment the system is introduced, the safeguards will follow, or will accompany, not follow, because it can't have a time lag on that. I also believe, this is my personal view, that the mid-segment of inverters in central space will start losing the sheen, because now, as we saw, that if you look at string inverters, we rarely find now 100 kilowatt inverter, for example. Generally, it is 20, 30, 50 kilowatt. But 100 kilowatt is generally not on the scene. Likewise, we had about 5-6 years ago, ABB offering 250 kilowatt inverter. Now it's not there. Soon, 500 kilowatt and 1000 also are becoming like a dinosaur. Like, you know, so either we'll have a 30 kilowatt inverter in course of time, or we might have 2 megawatt or 3 megawatt. Siemens displayed it in Intersolar. Many of you would have seen it. Now, another area, we talk so much about the payback and the revenue generation, and I think one of the simpler things is module cleaning in time. And I think there is a lot of possibility of new technologies in module cleaning system coming up, which means it should be effective, it should be quick, it may be automated, it should consume less water. So all these issues will become quite important in course of time. Other area where we have not really in India given much importance, and that is likely to gain currency, could be plant performance analysis. Because today I consider this as a great opportunity for investment, because we have 1 megawatt projects of IREDA where people are still encashing with 17.91 rupees. And if you tell him that you can produce one more unit by some method, then he sees 17.91 rupees coming to him. But if it is Rewa, then he sees a gain of ₹2.50. So the sense is there, if you go for phase one, batch one, where there are a lot of mistakes which have happened and the plant performance is low. So plant performance asset is another opportunity as I see. We all know, and we have talked about it, huge jump in rooftop opportunities, and there are many players in that. And OPEX model, in my opinion, will continue to grow in tandem, because more and more people will come, and rooftop people particularly would be the users whose prime objective is as a consumer. So they don't perceive themselves as an investor, and therefore the OPEX will grow in momentum. Distributed solar, of course, this is what Enphase is. I think it's okay. I'll just take a minute more. So I think I'll quickly go through AC system, micro inverter fitted modules, which is what has been talked about. Rise in rooftop opportunities will give more pressure for higher efficiency, and modules will gain more and more in higher space for the high efficiency modules. So these are the opportunities. Quickly I'll go. High efficiency cells and modules have a better future. Simplified tracker system, floating solar system, innovative financing, plant performance analysis, O&M business, and plant performance insurance, distinctly different from analysis, and EV charging stations. These are the areas we can play a role in all of them. If somebody wants us to give a report or working out a thing, we have done an analysis as to how a good module turns into a bad module because of loss of fill factor. Just to give you an idea, we have also done a project with 500 kilowatt solar tracker, and we believe now that even for smaller capacities, trackers will gain traction. Thank you very much.